guys, so now you're getting ready for Challenge Aruba. I just wanted to show you the feedback sports on the trainer. It's quite easy to set up. It shouldn't take that long at all. It's less than 2 minutes. So it has two nice little rubber bands here to hold the trainer together. So when you're carrying it around, it's nice and compact, stays together, doesn't fall apart on you. So you just take off the two bands. It's quite simple. You lay out the trainer. And it has nice adjustability here so that whatever size bike you have, it slides in and out. So once you expand it out there, you can take out the legs. Make sure you lock them in place. Flop back up. Then all you need to do is take your bike, obviously take the steer off, which I've already done. Take the front wheel off. Place it onto the steer of the bike, over the trainer. You just lock the steer into place then, obviously. Done that, you're ready to ride, obviously. So you just make sure your rear wheel is aligned on the rollers back here. I'm just going to tighten down the clamp here so it stays together. Parts really easy as well. Breaks down just as quick. So you just take the front skier, twist it up, get the bike off. Legs fold back up. Loosen this up. Then you got the bands again to strap back down. And you're all set. So a couple things that we talked about in the post that I just wanted to show you is the adjustability of the trainer, which you somewhat saw in the post or in the video just a second ago. So we have the adjustability forward and aft so that it doesn't matter the length of your bike, put all size bikes on it, it goes forward and aft. Then we also have some adjustability up here in the front. Let's see. So for the regular axle bikes, you have the regular skewer that goes through here, and there's also some adapters that come into play here that you can adapt in, so you can use it through axle bike if you'd like, some other mounts there. You can also reposition this with these holes here, so you just take out the four Allens, and you can move it to a different position if your bike's a kid's bike, or if you have something else you want to put on there that doesn't quite line up right height-wise. So you have a lot of adjustability with it to pretty much use any bike on it. It's just like a regular roller in the back. So it provides plenty of resistance, like we mentioned. I think it's a really solid trainer all around. It's obviously really good to travel with. I brought it here with me to Aruba. It was really windy outside today, so I stayed on the trainer for some intervals and got the good quality work in that I needed for the race. Thanks for watching.